Hello friends, this is Harish Bali from technofair.com. There are many apps that help establish network connection wirelessly between Android and Windows PC. Earlier, ShareIt was number one on my choice, but not now. Well, today I thought to take a fresh look at these apps and I picked up the best three ones for you. So let's check that out. First app I'm going to talk about is File Expert HD. Don't worry about links, they are all in the description of this video. This is one of the good file managers, very neatly organized. We are going to check to Tools tab and then move over to Share My Contents. Here there are two options, Use FTP and Share via Bluetooth. Bluetooth is slower, we'll follow Share via FTP. Point to note here is that both the devices, Android as well as Windows PC, should be on the same Wi-Fi network. First thing we need to do is enable share via FTP. I will need to enter this FTP URL on a web browser, then enter the username and the password given below. I have my phone's internal storage and a SD card right here. If I go to internal storage, let's go to DCIM folder, then open camera. Let me open a pic. This is a family click. I can simply do a right click and save it on my desktop. Let's go back. Now if I need to download this MP4 video, I simply need to click on it once and it will download. It hardly took 2 or 3 seconds to download a 8 MB video. Same way I can move my stuff from SD card to PC, the way I did it for internal memory. I can't see any link here on the browser that can help me move my content from PC to Android phone. For that, let's close all this and go to Windows Explorer. In this quick access box, type the FTP URL. Enter username and password that's visible on the device. This gives me a clear view of internal and external storage. Let me first go into internal DCIM. Let me create a new folder here by the name ABCD. Open this. Let's move a file from my desktop to this folder. That's it. Now I can access this particular folder from my Android device. I'll show you the same on my device as well. Here it is. Okay, let's now move back to SD card. SD card, here it is, DCIM folder, camera, and under camera I can select multiple images. For now I am clicking on 3, do a right click on the image, copy this to a folder or copy it on your system. Let me now exit the app from Android device from the bottom, exit, open this again. You may even explore other features of this file manager. Like under Tools, you have Network Clients. This is for sharing content with other devices on the network. Second app on my list is Feam V4. This works little differently because you will need to download an app for Android as well as an app for Windows. So both the versions are available on the respective Play Stores. Download that, I've already done that. Let's check it out. Let me first open Feam on my Android device. This is how the interface looks. I have already installed it on my Windows PC as well. It's available on the Windows Store. Opening this. When you open the app for the first time, you will notice that the app gives a unique name to the PC. Like in this case, it's given Kirby Vulture. And the name that it has given to my Android device is Zealous Hina. Since both my devices, Android and Windows PC, are connected with the same Wi-Fi network, so app connects automatically. This app offers chat functionality between the connected devices. This is useful as a reference text of the content shared rather than chat in its true meaning. Now if I need to share some content from my Android to PC, I'll tap on Zealous. Here it is. Let's say I type hi. Send. It's visible here. If I tap here again and write something. This is how chat functions. Now if I wish to share some attachments, I simply need to tap on this attachment link, tap on few photographs and simply send it from the bottom. And these attachments immediately move to PC. Here are the attachments. Same way, I can transfer content from my PC to Android device. So there's a choice whether I want to send files or folder. Let me do folder this time. It's a 40 MB folder. It's taken about 5 or 7 seconds to move this completely from PC to Android. In this example, both PC and Android devices were connected with the same Wi-Fi network, which is Ambitio here. Now, if I don't have a Wi-Fi router, there's a way out. I can turn on Wi-Fi direct settings both on my PC and Android device. Let's first do it on PC. Turn on Wi-Fi direct. Let's do the same on device as well, Android phone. Now, there's a password which is visible on the top on my Android device and a password on top of PC. I simply need to connect both, and without a router, file transfer or folder transfer can happen between both PC and Android. Feem also has got a blog on their website feem.io that has got some interesting information. For example, Wi-Fi direct on Feem, how to use it. You may read it and learn more about how to do that.
Third app on my list is Zender. Honestly speaking, this is the best interface among the three. Let's check it out.
I have already installed Zender on my Android device. Let me open this. This app has an amazing interface. It has also got a web interface. I'll open that for you quickly. Open web browser and type web.zender.com. Now, if I need to send something from my Android device to PC, what I need to do is simply click on send, and this will try and locate the other device, which is PC in this case. And below that, you can notice that there is a connect to iOS and connect to PC option. I'll click on connect to PC. Now, there are two options. Either I can scan the QR code from my Android device, or I can simply type 192.168 on a web browser. I'll prefer scanning. This has immediately connected both the devices. These are my pics of my last holiday. I love the interface of Zender. Look how well the complete information is organized on the left. There are images, videos, music. There are icons for everything. And the last one is for file manager. Let's go to images and check out how images look like. I can open any of the images and then continuously scroll between them one after the other. Let's go back. Good thing about Zender is that if I minimize this app on my Android device, it still continues running on my PC. Now, if I wish to download a particular image, I can simply download it. And if I need to download a couple of images, I can simply click on them and then download. All these images will get downloaded on my PC. In the same manner, I can even download videos. Not so good thing about this app is that I can't play video on the screen, while no other app allows that too. But I can play audio on the screen, which is really good thing about this particular app. Let's also have a look at how the file manager is organized. You can go to any folder. There's an option to rename the folder or any particular file inside the file manager. The second last icon from the bottom left is about apps. If you wish to move any of your apps from Android device to your PC, you can do that as well. We spoke about downloading content from Android device to PC, but if you wish to upload something, let's say an image, simply click on upload image and move the images from your PC to Android device. If I wish to delete any file or image or video from my Android device right from this app web.zender.com, I can do that using this delete button. Simply select the files and delete. So that's it about Zender. And of course, this is one of my favorite app.
So next time you think of a file or a folder transfer between Android and Windows, think wireless. Don't think of traditional methods like OTG cable or a USB cable. Well, what's your opinion about these three apps? If you know of a method which works even better, please put that in comments below. I would look forward to hear from you. If you have not subscribed to TechnoFair till now, please do that so you get notification for new videos. Thanks for your time.